Things you need to do before you retire. If you're looking forward to retirement, you're not alone. Every worker's dream is to leave their 9-to-5 jobs behind and enjoy the freedom and flexibility of retirement. But just because you think you're ready to retire doesn't mean your bank account agrees. In fact, some studies show that some will retire with less than $10,000 in savings. You need to take specific financial steps to ensure the comfortable and worry-free retirement you've always imagined. So, before you pull the trigger on retirement, be sure to follow this list to get you started on the path towards a successful retirement. 1. Plan, plan, plan. An obvious one, but it all starts with deciding to put the plan together. Once you figure out when you wish to retire, you can be able to lay out a solid foundation that will enable you to execute the retirement goal smoothly. A plan will help you develop a checklist that is smart without making any hasty decisions. It doesn't have to be a list of things that are too serious. It could be your ticket towards the longest vacation you'll ever take. So why not have fun while you're at it? 2. Know where your retirement income will come from. It seems obvious enough, but when you get to retirement, it's important to know which accounts to draw from and when. It's important to review and list guaranteed income sources, such as Social Security, pensions, and existing annuities. Not forgetting income-generating investments, such as IRAs, 401ks, taxable investment accounts, and savings accounts. Understanding how Social Security will impact your income and taxes after you begin claiming it as well is also something to consider. 3. Avoid lifestyle inflation. As you grow nearer to the retirement years, your income is also growing tremendously, at least for most people. With such a change in financials comes the temptation to splurge money on unnecessary liabilities. If you're looking towards retiring early, the best solution would be to maintain your budget and expenditures as if you were still a college student surviving on minimum wage. Okay, not to stretch it too far, but you get the point. Maintaining a reasonable budget before your retirement allows you to be flexible in terms of savings and enjoy the better part of your income when you no longer have to work for it. It may not sound very pleasing for someone living life on the edge, but to be reasonable is to be financially conscious. 4. Learn how Medicare works. With employment comes health insurance. What happens when you no longer serve the company you've devoted your time to? For those pushing 65 years and over, you'll most likely be relying on Medicare. Especially as we age, we become more and more susceptible to the need for medical care. You don't have to be on Medicare to know it's complicated and messy to understand. Even just comprehending what the Medicare annual open enrollment period is can be a task. Educate yourself on Medicare and how it works. Learn how much it would cost you to pay for premiums. Understand which coverage gaps you might face and whether your existing providers accept Medicare. Prepare to have the best coverage for you at a price you can afford and start learning about your new insurance before you have to use it. Even with Medicare, the cost of healthcare is continually rising. The good news, however, is that the more you educate yourself on what senior healthcare costs might look like, the better equipped you'll be to manage and keep them to a minimum. Along these lines, it pays to look into long-term care insurance, which can help defray some of the astronomical costs seniors face when they inevitably wind up needing a nursing home or assisted living care. You'll also be less likely to face unpleasant surprises. 5. Assess your personal savings. If you were fortunate enough, you probably spent much of your working years socking away money in an IRA or 401k. Any thought that involves retiring may require you to assess your balance and see what it actually means in terms of usable day-to-day cash. Having a lot of money is a good thing, but a figure such as $500,000 is also a good figure. And at first, you may think to yourself that you're well secured. The reality is that if the 4% yearly withdrawal rate is applied, it equates to about $20,000 of annual income, give or take some adjustments for inflation. This doesn't sound like much, considering retirement is forever. Of course, this is just your savings account and doesn't account for other income sources you might have at your disposal, like rental income or earnings from a part-time job. It also doesn't factor in Social Security. The point, however, is to look past the figure you see on your retirement plan statement and determine how much income it'll actually give you in practice. Having a greater pool of funds in your savings account buys you time until you figure out how your money could be reinvested into other things, making it sustainable. 6. Apply a reduced real property tax program. Since many states across the United States offer some form of tax relief to seniors, it would be great to weigh out all the options available to you to avoid financial binds that reduce your monthly cash flow. A scary study showed that many of the elderly lose their homes due to the inability to pay their real property taxes, and in some cases, the amount owed is less than $1,000. 7. Map out a retirement budget. Maybe you're used to following a budget and tracking your spending diligently. While that's certainly a positive habit to celebrate, once you stop working, your expenses are likely to change, either for better and/or for worse. While you might save money on things like commuting and transportation, you might spend more money on things like leisure, since you'll have ample free time at your disposal. Before you call it quits on work, create a new budget that details the expenses you expect to encounter once your career comes to a close. You may have to tweak that budget as you go along, but having one in place will give you a good sense of whether your nest egg will suffice during your golden years, or whether you'll need to save more money before making your retirement official. 8. Eliminate high interest debt. Should I get out of debt before I retire? This is a very common question among people who are looking to retire. The fact is that high interest debt is one of the biggest threats to a retirement budget, even if it's well funded. Credit card debt can carry an interest rate of up to 20%. In fact, paying off high interest rate debt is considered to be one of the highest priority items. One debt that a majority may ignore is the student loan debt. Student loan debt is something that follows you until the end. Jokes aside, what's not so funny about it is that the government can choose to withhold your Social Security benefits if you have outstanding student loans. 9. Develop a strategy for claiming Social Security. If you are like most seniors, Social Security will come to provide a large portion of your retirement income. This is a crucial part of a properly constructed retirement plan. Yes, there are wrong and right ways to claim your Social Security. And according to a recent study, nearly 96% of Americans are claiming their Social Security at a suboptimal time, collectively leaving $3.4 trillion on the table. That's $111,000 per household of lost retirement income due to claiming at the wrong time. But while your benefits themselves are calculated based on how much you earn during your career, the age at which you first file for them can cause that number to go up, go down, or stay the same. That's why it's important to create a strategy for claiming benefits rather than go in blind. For example, if you file for benefits at your full retirement age, you'll get the full monthly benefit you're entitled to based on your work history. If you delay past full retirement age, your benefits will get a boost. And if you file before full retirement age, you'll face a reduction in benefits, but you'll also get your money sooner. There's no right or wrong answer when it comes to choosing a filing age, but what you should do is know your full retirement age and understand the consequences of claiming benefits at various points in time. If you haven't started collecting Social Security benefits already, figure out when you'll do so. Do you need the money as soon as you retire, or would you rather wait? Also, read up on how your other sources of retirement income can affect the taxability of your Social Security benefits. Taxes on taxes? Yes, it gets taxed too. 10. Figure out what you'll do with your time. Though the idea of having all the free time in the world might seem appealing, once you find yourself in that situation, the reality might hit you hard. The truth is that it's difficult to go from a full-time work schedule to a total lack of structure, which explains why so many retirees ultimately fall victim to depression. To avoid this depression that might accompany not being around coworkers and not having a sense of purpose from going to work every day, make detailed plans for how you'll structure your days. Think about what will give you feelings of accomplishment and pleasure once you're retired. Make sure your plans align with your budget and income. You might think you'll go golfing twice a week and travel the world once a month. But if your savings can't support that lifestyle, you'll need to come up with a different plan. Think about joining meetup groups to socialize and do interesting activities, volunteering with charities whose work is meaningful to you, pursuing hobbies to the level of real mastery and expertise, even going into business for yourself. Also know that retirement has stages. Plan ahead for how you want to spend the first years after you leave work and what you think you may want to do later. 11. Coordinate timing with your partner. Retirement will be difficult for spouses who have not quite prepared for the transition. So it's not a surprise that retirement can make one feel lost, lonely, more dependent on their spouse. This in turn can lead to a new kind of marital stress. It's fun to think of retiring together and immediately embarking on your elaborate travel plans. But if you stagger your retirement, more of your retirement assets will stay invested. You'll also have the continued benefits from one of your employers. the medical coverage alone might have a significant impact. 12. Consolidate financial accounts. It's easier to keep track of your investment income if your accounts are in as few places as possible. Financial advisors suggest consolidating financial accounts to simplify record keeping and achieve easier cash flow tracking as you get ready for retirement. However, they also warn individuals to consider the consequences from a tax perspective prior to making any moves, such as selling stocks or mutual funds. 13. Reduce your portfolio's risk profile. The worst time to take a negative in your portfolio is right before retirement. It will directly affect how much you can live on during retirement. If you do not handle your risk profile and adjust your portfolio accordingly, you may end up working an extra 2 to 4 years because of failing to take this step when close to retirement. Well, folks, those are just a couple of things you should look out for before retiring. I hope you enjoyed the video and found value in it. As always, if you did, give this video a thumbs up and comment down below your thoughts. We love hearing your feedback. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing for more content like this. With that said, have a great day, you guys, and I'll see you all in the next one.